Tony Chocolonely is a quirky company. We started 11 years ago and we said together we want to make chocolate 100% slave free. And for that you need to know what slavery is.
Je suis Cam Samé Félix, j'ai 16 ans. J'ai travaillé dans une plantation de cacao de 1999 en 2003. Je n'étais pas payé. J'étais forcé de travailler.
Millions of children, yes.
Working as slaves.
I realized that I needed to take my responsibility as a consumer. And after talking to one of Dutch's finest professors in criminal law, I decided to prosecute myself for buying and eating chocolate.
November 29, 2005 brengt Teun de eerste slaafvrije chocoladereep op de markt. Tony Chocolonely is geboren.
I approached the company in 2007. In 2011 I took a 51% share within the company. My personal drive came from building a brand that makes a difference within a category in the supermarket. That was my aim. I think everything starts with listening and understanding. So the first thing I did is grab my backpack and actually go to Ghana and Ivory Coast to see what's going on in the field. And I was really shocked because if you live in Amsterdam and you realize selling chocolate with a nice wrapper is the game that you want to be in, I think it is different. It is different if you see what's really going on. And the moment I saw it, the company went under my skin. Every night I was dreaming about how can we actually do something about delivering impact in Africa. And what I found out is that if the commercial makes impact, it can be more commercially successful. So it's a combination of the two. So we need to make impact, and if we make impact, we will be commercially successful. So those two are not fighting to each other, it's actually strengthening each other and making more headway. We have three steps, and then we call that the roadmap. First step is people have to be aware that there's a problem. Second step, we have to take everything that we have to deliver from bean to bar the right message and do the right thing so that we can be proud of the bars that we sell. And then thirdly, we want to deliver a business model that is scalable. If it's not scalable, then others will say, yeah, that only works for them, but it doesn't work apply to me. But we want to prove that each and every chocolate company, no matter how big they are, they can make the same impact that we can. And if a big company makes a tiny step forward, it has far further impact than us making a giant leap forward. We're just a tiny company, but we play a role by actually opening their eyes to inspire them to take their responsibility seriously as we do. And if we all do that and pull the responsibility towards us, then I fundamentally believe that the world will change. We always say we're crazy about chocolate, and not meaning that we're completely wappy. No, we're dedicated and passionate to deliver the best tasting chocolate in the world. And we're serious about people, five kind of people. So firstly, it's the team. Team Tony is the most important. If you have the right people that are fired on, they can deliver the result on impact and commercially. Secondly, the farmers. Thirdly, is the consumer. Fourthly, is the customer. So the Albert Heijn and the Wereldwinkel and the Jumbo, but also the Whole Foods market in the US. And fifthly, is the supplier. And if you work with all these five kinds of people together, then you can make impact. But the most important is culture. If you have the right people in that are really dedicated to make it happen and they operate in a culture that everybody wants to be part of and everybody is fired on, then my role is not to push people further, but to really tell people to go home. And that's the company that you want to be leading, right? And I say leading, but I don't mean leading. I see my role as laying a fundament. A fundament on which people can flourish and can do things that they would never ever imagine that they could do. And make mistakes, not twice the same mistake, only once, so that you learn out of it. And if they make a mistake, they can blame me, because I want them to make a mistake and to move forward. And if you feel the security in a surrounding where you can make mistakes, then you can do so much more than you would ever imagine.
So
we are social with each other, we are interested, we are curious, we are really working together as a team. And we also are working as a team for that mission and to be social for the world, to be social for other people, for our farmers, for the people who works for this. That can be inspiring for everyone, and I like to be inspiring to others too. So that's why I work here.
I just focus on the internal use, and if we make impact with the farmers and we take care of our own team, then there's no reason that other people don't join and eat Tony Chocoloni. So be transparent and make sure that you worry about reality instead of your image. Consumers are really changing. Students don't want to work at a company that pollutes the world or actually makes inequality bigger. So people want to put their effort and their money towards a cause that's really stepping forward and makes the world a nicer place. And if you realize that consumers and people that are working are willing to team up with companies that really take that seriously and don't care about the image anymore, but honestly, is that company making impact, real impact, then I want to be part of that team as consumer or as employee. So it takes a couple of years. We don't have to prove to the people that are used to the system that is of yesterday. We have to prove to the people of the system of tomorrow that this will happen. And yeah, let's be arrogant and let's be naive, but let's think that we can change the world, because we can. One step at a time, we can. I think that social enterprise is the right label. It is a label to actually say that those companies are different from companies that we're used to. Just my personal opinion is that the companies that we're used to are wrong. If you twist up goal and mean, and money is a mean, it will always be a mean. We call it a betaalmiddel in Dutch, and can never be a goal in the end. So if you twist your goal and your mean and you say we're a company and we make profit, yeah, good luck to you. Because that is not the company that I want to put my effort in. And many years ago, there were social companies as well. People working to do good for their own team and for their own employees. And at this time, the society is at such a level that we don't have to really put special effort in our team, because people are doing really well. But we have to take the responsibility over the value chain. And what I see today is that the world gets so much richer on one hand and so much poorer on the other hand. And this is not a sustainable way of actually building a society on the whole planet. You have to work together to make the beginning of each and every value chain a little bit more richer. Richer is not the right word, but access to more money, and the end of the value chain a little bit poorer. My pride is when I look in the mirror each and every morning, I just want to see a face that is really happy because it does the right things. And you only have a limited amount of energy. And if you can address that energy to a cause that makes you happy, then you're doing the right thing. A couple of years ago, I had some health issues. I had a stroke, I couldn't talk for 7 months. And in that period, you really get internally focused. You want to get better. And once my speaking ability was back, I had the fact, okay, I got a second chance of actually prove to people that you have to do something worthwhile with your life. And I was so much aware of the fact that I was living in extra time. I always call it, this is my extra time, and I'm gonna enjoy it, and I'm gonna make it happen. And we get a lot of remarks from customers saying, well, why is the bar unequally divided? Because it changes. So when the bar is naked on the table, then the whole full story is actually on the table. Thank you. Wow, lekker man.